Hello and welcome once again to Shepherd of the Valley's weekly video service. I'm Pastor Dave Deckard. It is always a joy to have you with us. We are right in the middle of November, holidays coming up. Hope that they are relatively non-stressful for you, or at least stressful in the right ways. Either way, we are glad that you came here for this moment of rest and retreat where we will all bask in the glow of God's love for us through God's Word. We're going to get to that in just a minute, but as we do, let us pray together the prayer of the day. O God of justice and love, you illumine our way through life with the words of your Son. Give us the light we need and awaken us to the needs of others through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord comes among us this day through the words of the Gospel of Matthew, the 25th chapter. Jesus said to the disciples, "Then the kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. When the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them, but the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, all of them became drowsy and slept. But at midnight there was a shout, 'Look, here is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him.' Then all those bridesmaids got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish said to the wise, 'Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out.' But the wise replied, 'No, there will not be enough for you and for us. You had better go to the dealers and buy some for yourselves.' And while they went to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later the other bridesmaids came also, saying, 'Lord, Lord, open to us.' But he replied, 'Truly I tell you, I do not know you. Keep awake, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour.'" The Gospel of our Lord. So in this story, Jesus gives an illustration about the kingdom of heaven. And as always, we want to take a time out here because when Jesus talks about kingdom of heaven, he's not really talking about some kind of afterlife. He's talking about the living, breathing work of God among us. In other words, if you want to see God's Spirit at work, if you want to see what it looks like when God's stuff interacts with the world and the world is transformed into what it's supposed to be instead of just what it is, that's the work of the kingdom of heaven. And in this parable, Jesus compares the kingdom of heaven to a bridegroom who's coming, and you know it's for a big celebration. You know it's a good thing. That's not in question. You know the bridegroom is coming. You don't know exactly when or how. May come from this way, may come from that way. More importantly, may come 2 seconds from now, may come 2 hours from now, or as it turns out in the parable, was a little hard to see. It didn't come for quite a while. And there are 10 bridesmaids who are awaiting the coming of the bridegroom, and they have one job: keep their lamps lit so that they can celebrate, light the way. Everybody can see the bridegroom coming. The bridegroom can see light and goodness through them. Works both ways. That's their whole job in this affair, is when he comes, stand up, light those things, and escort the bridegroom into whatever is supposed to happen, okay? But here's the thing, the bridegroom is late and the oil kind of runs out for some of them. And 5 of them shepherd their lamps pretty well, and 5 of them do not. 5 of them are ready, anticipating the event and doing whatever it is that they need to do in order to prepare themselves and to be prepared for the bridegroom to come. And 5 of them are kind of like, well, we'll figure it out, or this isn't that important, or we're just lazy, or whatever it is, right? So when the bridegroom comes, 5 of them are able to live out their purpose, while 5 of them go scrambling and ultimately can't do it. And Jesus says, this is what the kingdom of heaven is like. You got to be ready for it. You don't know when it's going to be there. And oh, I could tell you 1,000 stories of how this is lived out in my otherwise pretty ordinary life. One of the things I've learned as a pastor and a person of faith is never to take any moment for granted. because you don't know the moments that are going to be important. I've worked in ministry for, almost 20 years now. And I've been through several generations of people, including a lot of youth and kids, whom I have worked with quite closely. And I will tell you, there's nothing like working with youth or young people that will teach you this. Because you think that you're going to walk in there with the wisdom and with the knowledge, and you're going to say, blah, 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 blah. And all of a sudden, their lives are going to transform. And they go, oh, Pastor, that is so wise, and now I have changed my whole life because of what you said in this moment. That, friends, is a pipe dream. That never happens. First of all, you ain't that brilliant. Second of all, you're not that good of a communicator, especially across the generational divide. And third of all, you have no idea what they might need to hear in this day. Unless you are very fortunate where they open up to you or whatever and you can get a read on that, you are shooting in the dark. So you cannot come in and give pronouncements from on high and dispense wisdom that seems good to you because it doesn't really relate to them. You know what you have to do? You have to spend a lot of little moments with them. Playing games and riding buses and walking down streets and eating hamburgers and doing whatever it is that you do in little, small, ordinary moments. And if you spend enough of those little ordinary moments with them, being enmeshed with them, listening, talking, doing all that stuff, you will find in the end that you hit the one that you were supposed to be there for, but you never knew that it was going to be the one. And sometimes you don't find out until much, much later that it was. I have had this happen again and again. People that I knew as 13-year-olds and 16-year-olds will show up 10, 15 years later, and they will say, you know what? I remember this. We did this on this day, or you said this thing, which, first of all, you don't even remember saying it, and second of all, you sure didn't say it in such grandiose terms as they remember it. But your little comment or your little action on some random Tuesday 15 years ago is what ended up opening up possibilities for joy and light and beauty in their life. The bridegroom arrived, but you couldn't predict it. All you could do was keep that lamp lit day after day, burger after burger, game after game, event after event, moment after moment. And because you kept that lamp lit and the possibility of that relationship open, there was light when there needed to be. And we can celebrate it, and your life and their life changed because of it. That's exactly what the kingdom of heaven is like. It doesn't rest on your knowledge. It doesn't rest on your power, on your good works, on your desire to change the world. You won't, probably, in those terms. But it does rest on being ready for any moment with any person to be full of more goodness and reason for thanksgiving than it would have had that moment not happened between you. And that is true of moments like with a bank teller or a barista or a checkout clerk at the store. It is true of moments with your kids and your cousin's kids and your grandchildren. It is true with your friends. It is true with your spouse. It is true with everyone. That our job is not to control relationships or to stand on high apart from relationships trying to illuminate the world. Our job is to carry that lamp between you and me and make sure that when the work of the Spirit happens, we see it, celebrate it, and participate in it together, no matter where, no matter when, and no matter with whom. And the only way I know how to do that is to treat every person you meet as if the bridegroom were coming among you. Treat every person you meet as if they were worthy of you shining your best light upon that situation and that person. Treat every person you meet as if they have a lamp too that is illuminating something important about the world through their eyes and their lives. And take the time to honor and to shine in that moment. And when you are together in love like that, you will find the world a lot brighter and fuller of good things and reasons for celebration than you ever imagined. The parable's really clear. If this doesn't happen, if you just try to wait and guess the moment or guess the person or choose, I'm going to be nice to this person and that person doesn't matter, you will be like the bridesmaids without oil, striking that lamp and when you think you need it and it's just not lighting up. And that's not going to stop the party. That's not going to stop the work of the Spirit. It will go on in your midst, whether or not you are a part of it. God does not subject God's self to our weaknesses or our conceit. But it is a lot better to have your lamp lit and to let that light shine and to be a part of the purpose that you're here for than it is to try to guess at that purpose or try to pick and choose who you will share it with and end up empty as a result. The light is yours today. The light is mine too. Let us share it together and share it with the people around us so that we too can know cause for celebration and can honor and shine before and with each other. Amen.
Sing a song, sing out loud, sing out strong, sing of good things, not bad, sing of happy, not sad. Sing a song, make it simple to last your whole life long. Don't worry that it's not good enough for anyone else to hear. Just sing a song.
Having heard God's word, let us pray together. Dear Lord, much of our life is unknown. Even the course of our own lives, we can't chart with any reliability as much as we try, let alone the course of the world and the environment around us. We ask that you remind us that ours is not to know the day or the hour of all things that will come, but rather to be ready to meet anything that comes with the mercy, the joy, and the light of your Son, Jesus Christ. who loved us through all events, occasions, and types of moments, and poured his grace into us like oil into a lamp. Help us keep our lamps lit to shine for others. Help us be on the lookout for the lamps of others as well, and most of all, for the coming of opportunities for joy and love, that we might see them and celebrate them together in your name. Amen. And speaking of opportunities for joy and togetherness, we invite you to gather now bread and wine or whatever you have on hand so we can celebrate together the wedding feast that unites us all, the sacrament of Holy Communion. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us pray together the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We invite you now to take the bread and the cup and to share them with the people next to you, saying, "The body of Christ given for you and the blood of Christ shed for you." And if you are watching this by yourself, you may partake of the elements as I offer them to you, knowing that God is with you where you are, every bit as much as God is with all God's children across the world. This is the body of Christ given for you. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. The body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace, now and forevermore. Amen. We hope that your month is going well. If you want to visit with us, you can always find me at the email pastor@sov-id.org. Or if you live in the Boise area, come see us 10 o'clock a.m. Sunday morning, right at the corner of Victory and 5 Mile behind the Maverick Station. We'd be happy to say hello to you. Or you can always find us right where you found this sermon, our YouTube channel, which is My Boise Church, our website, myboisechurch.org. However you find us, we are glad that you are here and know that God walks with you through all the steps of your week, and may they overflow with love and joy for you and all the people around you. Amen.